सो गाइस, टुडे आज हम देखेंगे कि सिस्को पैकेट ट्रेसर का प्रोग्राम कैसे करें विदाउट कोडिंग नॉलेज। सो लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड। सो फर्स्ट वी विल पुट द मशीन्स, दैट इज पीसी। आई विल पुट हियर वन पीसी, जस्ट ड्रैग एंड ड्रॉप देयर, थर्ड एंड देन फोर्थ। देन वी विल नीड स्विच फॉर कनेक्टिंग देम, जस्ट क्लिक ऑन द स्विच। देयर विल बी द जेनेरिक स्विच, क्लिक ऑन दैट एंड ड्रैग एंड ड्रॉप हियर। Another switch will be required, just drag here. Now for connecting these two networks we will require routers. Just go to in router section and select generic router and drag here. Another router we will require. So our machines and routers are done. So we have to establish now connection. For establishing connection, there will be the physical connection we have to establish. Select this cable, just click on that and then click on this PC to switch to router. You don't have to change the cable which we have to use. The packet tracer automatically detect which should be, just a second, which cable should be used. There is the serializable cable for connecting the routers. Just you have to click on that. So our physical connection is done. So we have to go to the logical connection, that means IP address. So giving the logical, I will select not. Just click here, type any IP you want. 0. This will be the, again I am doing here also 192.168.2.0. So the two networks are connected. But the intermediate network is also we have there. So we have to create logical connection there also. So I will give just a second. 10.12.1. Remember, you can give any IP address as your requirements. So first we will customize our PC to establish our logical connection. That means IP address. Just cancel here. Press escape to cancel this, then click on the PCs, go to the desktop IP configuration. Here you type the IP address of this PC, 192.168.1.1. sorry, 1 will be the for the router, .2. Subnet mask router will create. So default gateway nothing but the which router is you are connected to the network. So I will give 192.168.1.1. This IP address I will give to the router. That will be the later part. So just click on the cross and then go to the another machine. Again same IP, 192.168.1.3. 192.168.1. It is pretty much easier. Just you have to customize all the machines IP configuration. Here it will the 192.168.2.1. Sorry, 2. Subnet mask is created. Now default gateway. Default gateway will be the IP address of this router. So this will be the 192.168.2.1. That's it for this. Now desktop IP configuration 192.168.2.1. So we don't require to give the logical address to switch because it works on physical layer, data link layer, that is MAC address. So we will configure our routers. Go to the router, configure. If you have knowledge about the coding, you can go and CLI and you can type here. But I will give you simple way. Go to the fast ethernet, just type here IP address 192.168.1.1. subnet mask automatically, click on the on and just close this. Again go to this router, same fast Ethernet 0, 192.168.2.1. Click on, clock, cancel this again. So our network is created. Here you can see the green dots, means this network is created and this network is created, but these two routers are not still connected. To connect this router, we will require this IP address. That's face. So click on this router, go to the serial 2A, just click here and enter this IP address 10.12.1.1. That's it. Subnet mask, click on. Go to this router, serial 2A. That's it. Done it. So here you can see now green signal. It means our connection is now established. But we are doing this process in the RIP. RIP is nothing but information protocol, router information protocol. So means this router should know which network he has connected. So go to the RIP section and just click here and type this IP address in here. So I will type 192.168.1.0. just click on the add. Here it will, the automatic code will be generated. If you want to do the coding, you can do also. The another connection it is connected is 10.12. so 10.12.1.0, sorry, 10.12.1. just click on the add. Same configuration for this RIP 10.12.1.0. That's it. So we will verify our connection is established or not. So you can go to the here the package, click on this machine, and I'm clicking this machine. Here it is showing failed. So failed means it is showing the time elapses required. So we will go to the this there. You can adjust the time limit. I will set it 64,000. And then for this router, you don't have to set time. Here it will be the option not set. So again we will try. First we will try to make the connection between two routers. So I will send myself first to second router. It is showing again fails. Just a second. Successful. Here you can see. So we will try to now send the message from this PC to this PC. So let's try again. Successful. For doing the stimulation work, means how the actual data is going, just click on the real time back click and click on the auto capture play. I will close that window. Here you can see the message from coming from them is, just a second, I will send again the message PC to PC. The previous message is sending. Here you can see the message is coming to the switch. After reading that message, the message will go to the router. Here you can see the previous message is gone, and the confirmation of this message will be come again for the message delivery or successful delivery of the message. Here you can see. That's it, friends. Thank you for this watching the video.